Video, we are going to see how to design this into actual HTML and CSS. Just to give you an overview, we have a container. Inside the container we have h3, and inside the h3 we have span with text pricing, and then after the h3 closes we have our row. Inside the row we have first column, second column and third column, and inside the column we have the h6, then h4, then h6 again, and then we have paragraph, and then we have a button. That's it. Fine, now let's design. So on the head tag we have a font awesome icon Roboto and an external style sheet. So let me remove all the added style sheet. And on the HTML, let me remove the unnecessary code. So this is not unnecessary code, this is previously created code. And this is the font family, and this is the font awesome, which we don't need for this video. And we have external style sheet, and this is the external style sheet. Now we have container. Inside the container we have h3, and on the h3 we have a text, and in between the h3 we have span tag, and after the h3 we have a row. Inside the row we have column. Inside the column we have h6, let's say, and then we have h4, some text, and then we have h5, some text, and then we have paragraph. We need 3 lines, and then we have button, some text. Now let's fill the text. Starter, we have made it. And then get start. Copy this and one more time. So let me add the HTML and show you afterwards. And I have added the HTML. Not only we are just going to design for desktop, we'd be designing this for tablet as well as for the mobile screen. Fine, now just to show you the actual HTML, how does it looks. Control O so that I can open the file on the browser. And on the desktop I have placed the folder, and the file name is index.html. fine, this is how it looks. Now let's style. We have container. Inside container we have h3. Inside h3 we have span. Then inside container we have a row. Inside row we have column. And inside column we have h4, h6, h4, h5. So h6. H4, H5, then we have paragraph, then we have button. Cool. Now render it, we need 100 pixel for desktop, and this is what you get. And whatever is there inside, I want text align center. And I want these row to be of to be side by side. So display flex. Now I want to give the width to the column, so flex basis, let's say 28%, refresh it, and I want align item center, and no, I don't want align item center, I want align item flex start, justify content space around, in between I need spaces, so I got these spaces. Now let me give padding to the column. First let me give background to the body, background red, just to fill the color, and I have copied the color, refresh it. This is how it looks, and I want the column to have background white, and let's add the padding, top bottom 20 pixel left right 0, I think top bottom 30 pixel would be right. Now let's work on the H3. I want the color to be white, and let's add the font size 30 pixel and a margin bottom of 25 pixel. Cool. Now inside this span, let's have the color. So let's have this color. Cool. Now we need to properly give the spacing. So after monthly we need 25 pixel, and after last paragraph we need 25 pixel. So after monthly, what comes? Margin bottom 25 pixel. And after paragraph, which is last child, I want margin bottom of 25. That doesn't seem to work. Fine, not an issue, we'll look at it. So first design the starter. Select this and add font size 35 pixel. And then we have pixel. Okay, everything seems alright. Now let's choose the paragraph and give the color gray and margin bottom 10 pixel. Cool. And let's add the font size 18 pixel. Select all and give to the paragraph. Now let's choose the last child. So column, inside the column we have paragraph, inside the column we have paragraph, and I want to choose the last child. So as of last child will not work. In case in place of last child you have to use nth child. So the last child for the column is button, so which is 1. So for the second last, it's going to be paragraph. Now if I refresh, so let's try with the paragraph. Refresh this, and now you got it. Now in this, what we need to do is we need to have margin bottom 25. Refresh it, and you got some extra space. Now let's work on the button. Along with the button, we need some space between the starter as well, so which is H6. So margin bottom 25 and cool. Let's design the button. Background red. Let's add linear gradient. The first color is not need not to be black. Let's place our color. Actually, I haven't copied, I guess. For next color, let's place this. And now let's add the padding 20 pixel on all sides, top bottom 10 pixel, left right, and then remove the border and outline and add the color white, and border radius 20 pixel. Cool. Now place this. Refresh it, and here you go. Now left and right, it should be 40. And let's add the font weight, or let's say text shadow, 1 pixel left and right, 1 pixel top and bottom, 1 pixel blur, and color black. Refresh it, and I believe we have completed everything. Now for the last change, so let's select till the column and select last child. So now last child will work because it's a container. Row is a container, and inside the container we have 3 child, so call itself a container. In previous case, the paragraph was not a container, it's a single list. So on the last child, let's add the background on this color. Let's add the color white, and need the paragraph as well. Select all, and then inside the paragraph the same, and here you go. Now if you want, you can increase the flex spaces, which in other word it is column width 30. Cool. Now let's work on the responsiveness. Let's get into the mobile. So since we are going to use responsiveness, we are going to target the screen size. So Bootstrap breakpoint. So here we are going to particularly target our screen size, which are for mobile and desktop. Let's target mobile and desktop. So this breakpoint is for mobile and this breakpoint is for desktop. So there's a concept in responsiveness which is mobile first. We need to first design for the mobile. So let's design for the mobile first, and then we'll come to the desktop. So this is mobile, and select the row and use the flex wrap and paste it for the row. Now since we have made it flex wrap, let's try to decrease the flex spaces. That doesn't seem to work. Let me refresh again. So this is column, this is second column, this is third column. Let's select the column . Let's remove the margin 50 pixel top and bottom, left and right. Let me make this 20 pixel. So let me change it 20 pixel left and right. Select all. And for left and right, it is going to be top and bottom, it is 100. Refresh it. So this is for what do we call mobile. I need this flex spaces to be 40, but for desktop it should be 30. I think we need to make this 49. Now that's cool. So for mobile, for the last column, what I need is, so let's choose the last column, so which we have targeted with the help of yen child. So here we'll use flex base, flex grow as 1, so it takes the entire space. And let's add margin bottom for all columns. Margin top for 30 pixel. And cool, this is from mobile. And for desktop we have a problem. Let's see what we can do with it. Let's reduce the flex size to 28. Yeah, it is because of the flex grow property. Let's make this 0, refresh it, that works for desktop. And for mobile also it is okay. So till 768 it is for mobile. So once it reaches above 768, it is going to be, once it is from 768 to 992, this is going to be for tablet. So let's select the same for the element for the tablet. So let's select 800 So this is for tablet. So what modification we need? If we want, we can increase the call size. So I believe the tablet is also okay. So this is going to be mobile, this is going to be tablet, and this is going to be desktop. So that's all for this video. Thank you so much for listening. So in case if you want to have some margin, we can add it with on the container. Top, bottom, left, right, 50. So let's make this 50.